Hello everyone, I contact you today and urge you to listen to this story of Hariro, a young girl subjected to female genital mutilation. You're also going to hear an account from the doctor who will explain what treatment she requires. And the reason I'm speaking with you is to urge you to support us, to help us to raise between £500 to £1,000, £500 to provide the emergency medical treatment. And anything above this, we will use this to provide for ongoing care and also to further raise awareness of the issue, working with those affected by FGM. The video also contains an email which you can use to contact us direct. Within the description section of the YouTube video, we will place a link where you can donate monies direct as well. Following her treatment, we will try and follow Hariro's journey and make sure we come back to you to explain what has been done with any funds that you do donate to us. So please, I urge you to consider donating so we can help Hariro and raise awareness of FGM. Thank you very much for your help and thank you for listening.
Hariro, I was taken somewhere recently. My mom only told me that she's going to take me to my favorite restaurant. And then I followed her, dressed up. I was quite happy when we left. And then when we took the car, the driver took us to another place. Then I told my mom, this is not the restaurant. Why are you taking me to this one? She told me to keep quiet since he's going to do something for me which will benefit me. I wondered what could that be, but I trusted her since she was my mom. When I went to the house, I saw some men and a lady. They greeted me well, gave me drinks, and I was quite welcome, which was quite good. But then the end result was not good. The lady took me to a certain room where she told me to lie down and to feel free. And then I asked her, okay, if I lie down, what are you going to do? Then she told me she wants to do some circumcision with me. I told her, that's not, I don't want it. Then she called the guys, they tied me up. I resisted as long as I could, but they beat me up till I passed out. When I woke up, I saw blood all over my body. There was food everywhere. It was very, very disheartening.
I don't remember that day. It was the worst day of my life.
This is very emotional for her.
We had to stop.
When I went home, I asked my mom why she did that. Then she told me it's a tradition which has to be followed. And there's a man who asked for my hand in marriage. I told her I don't want to get married. I told her I was not ready for marriage since I was running. She told me my dad has already decided and she cannot go against him. Then I told her that I was feeling a lot of pain and I would like to see a doctor so that I can be treated and feel well. And then we discussed the issue. But then she told me no. Like, she told me she is expecting me that I will tell the doctor everything and that she will be arrested, her and dad. So I just hurt her. The wound was getting worse day by day. They did not even stick me well. I could not even go to the toilet. Then one day I was sent to school, but I did not go to the school. I went to see a doctor. I went to see a doctor and I was admitted there. I was treated. The doctor asked me what happened to me and told him everything. He told me, don't worry, that he will treat me, and he gave me food. Currently I'm at the hospital, and since that day I did not call my parents, because if they get to know where I am, I don't know what they are going to do. They might even do something bad to me. They might hide me, because they are a reserved family. They don't want the girls to go elsewhere without their permission.
Good evening, doctor.
Good evening.
Please introduce yourself.
My name is Dr. Mbatia Kanyare from Senior Hospital.
How did you meet Hariro?
Hariro's case, just like many of the other girls, was brought to this facility by a lady of goodwill. who also supposedly happens to be a local community health worker from the neighborhood she hails from.
How many such cases do you usually receive?
I cannot stipulate any amount, but normally it's usually about 3 to 4 cases per month. But during this pandemic period, we have really seen the numbers escalating following all schools closure countrywide, leaving these girls predisposed to this vice. And
please tell us about Hariro's case.
For Hariro's case, it's something quite not seen quite often. So she came in with complaints of an oozing wound. The wound was kind of gangrenous, it was a gangrenous genital wound that was quite septic. It was done a partial cut of the labia following very aseptic techniques. And it's something not quite often seen, as the stitches were done using normal thorns from the thickets.
Do you think she'll be fine?
She will be fine, but it will take quite a lot, because she needs quite a lot. She needs some medical treatment, she needs some surgical treatment, and as well she needs some psychological treatment to help her cope with the heinous act that was performed to her. Currently, she has been to the OR for surgical toileting and debridement of the aseptic wound, while still we are waiting to get her to theater for genital rejuvenation to correct the vice that was performed at her. We have also tried to incorporate some help from psychologists who tried to get some sessions with her, because literally she is suffering both physically, mentally, psychologically, at least to try and help her cope with the whole situation and to help her recover from this PTSD.
Thank you so much for your help.